Okay, we're at the Rob Healy GoFundMe ride day slash birthday celebration. I think he's turning like 72 or something today. But we have the triumphant return of Jack Finn.
In order to stay under the emissions
the world's oldest mountain bike racer.
So it's I've been saying for 3 years.
Bought a new Honda.
Since Guy,
I told him he should have got a Husky with the lower suspension.
Yamaha 450. I've been saying the Japanese.
But got my buddy Mark Sands here from Spain, owner of MX Golf, where we rode the Stark, and this other buddy Mark. Two Marks. There's many. Is Mark the most common name in Spain? But
not enough with one, two.
Two. It's Mark squared. So we have him on the 25YZ 450 today. Got him dialed in with his personal number.
Super grateful.
motocross vacation in Southern California. LA County today, Glen Helen tomorrow, Fox Friday, full week.
Here you go.
So, where have you ridden in California before? Zaka?
My last track from California, I think it was Pala Raceway.
Oh, okay.
In 2015.
How long ago?
7 years ago.
Oh, okay, when it was still Pala. Before us Fox.
When the name is Pala.
Yeah. Okay. So you have your own track in Spain.
Yeah.
How many years have you had MX Golf now?
3 years. 3 years.
3 years.
Yeah.
So it just opened. It was new when I came there for the start.
Yeah. When you came, it was the first year.
Okay.
Years I started the track.
Yeah. Sorry, everyone. MX Golf smokes all these tracks in California. Chicken, why? What's the story behind 111 as a retired racer?
I always thought it was a cool looking number. I don't know. It's clean looking. That's it. No story behind it.
No story behind it. Because
no.
I remember for years you just straight up ran the one.
Well, I was number one.
Yeah. But even at Milestone, like when you're retired, you kept the one.
I ran it for a while, yeah.
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 But so
then I ran out of number one plates.
So no reason behind the 111, just you like it.
I thought cool. It looks clean.
Yeah. So I think in AMA, don't they reserve 111 for like a visiting Euro or something?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
So you're a European at heart.
If I want to make a comeback, I don't know if I'll be able to get it.
Did you ever race with 111? With Mitch, right?
Yeah, I did. That's why it's 111. Okay. I raced, that's right.
Maybe
I raced 1 year with 111.
Yeah. There you go. Good reason.
That's why.
So we're at the Rob Healy GoFundMe ride day, but it's actually a birthday celebration. So how old are you now?
I'm 65.
65. I remember when Ross turned vet pro. You know, at Ascot, 30 years old pro, I remember going, fuck, can you still ride when you're that old? And now I'm 56 and it's like, Jesus.
Actually, if you told me when I was like in my 20s, I'd be riding when I was 35 or 40, I never thought in the world I would. And now I started riding with 11, so I've been riding 51 years.
Jesus.
That's half a century.
But here's what's crazy, right? You still move pretty well and you do all the jumps and it's like you ride better than you walk.
Yeah, definitely.
You
definitely
know,
like, ride better than I walk.
And it's like does the dirt bike make you feel equal?
I have distress about my physical condition because my body's so beat up over the years. I need to get some surgeries and I'm planning to do next year. Hopefully I need a knee replacement, I need back surgery, etc. But what it does is it gives me life. Like it makes me feel like I'm still worthwhile to live, I guess.
Yeah, because you're still good at something.
Yeah, you're still good at something and you can do these obstacles. And for some guy my age, it's really fulfilling, you know, and rewarding, you know, because not everybody can. Some guys can, they decide not to at that age, you know, so.
Yeah, what is it? Is there anything for you with motocross as far as your age where you hold back now, or do you still just go as fast as you can?
I do, but I just can't because physically I can't go from sitting to standing quickly because of my atrophy in both my knees. Most of my knees need to be replaced in my back. So I know technically I could do skill wise, I can't. So it kind of holds back, and then, and the turns, but you know what? I've never been fast enough with the turns. That's a lifelong quest, you know, the turns,
yeah.
The corners.
So yeah, that's good. Cause like still for me, I'm still a knucklehead enough that I won't ride a vet track, you know? So like I make myself do all the jumps on the main track. And I think that's a stupid male ego thing, but it keeps me feeling young, you know?
Yeah, it just keeps you feel like you're vital, you know?
Yeah.
And you know, you think about people, I mean, you're not that far behind me, but your age or my age, what do they do? Like most people are 65 or in their 50s.
Yeah,
what do they do? Like what is their recreation? They might play golf. I mean, who knows? Maybe some of them play tennis or whatever. I don't know. But most of the guys I know, your age or even my age, they don't do much.
Yeah.
And they watch sports.
Yeah.
You know?
we're doers, not beers.
Yeah, they watch sports. and their hobby's drinking beer.
Yeah.
Well, that's not a bad hobby, but you know.
Thanks, bro.
To my friend Mark from Spain, he brought me a freaking gift. Look at this. Hey, he bought me a Bell Moto 10 spherical. Had it painted by his buddies at Living. The numbers, the name. Golf MX is his track. It's fucking crazy paint job, but look at this, guys. It's got Swapmoto, my brother's logo. Come on, are you serious? Look at my dog. And you know, she loves the pup cup, so she's got all the ice cream there. Dude. Between this and that last helmet I got, I'm set for life.
Helen, this is my third day in a row of riding a dirt bike.
Yeah, I mean, that's why you just got on the track, no sight lap, nothing, just gone.
Well, I mean, most people would think that was a dream week, right?
I guess so.
I missed my mountain bike.
You still have your training wheels on?
Yeah.
We'll go.
I think I'm gonna, well, I'm taking these guys to Fox Raceway tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
Maybe I'll go Skyline after that.
Yeah, I can, I'm going to Miami tomorrow. You wanna go to Miami?
No. Say hi to Will Smith. Hey, Marvin! After Glen Helen, we came to the shop. Aiden washed my bike for me. What do you think? I told him it's like a 6 out of 10. But we're building up the RM Army right now. Wait, first, news alert. Chase says he's racing Saturday. Racing?
like putting those numbers to use. We'll see. I'm gonna have to go race too to witness it. This teenage womanizer, bike washing specialist, Aiden. And here's Alex Ray's RMZ 450, complete with KYB suspension. The biggest improvement on the bike is the KYB shock, getting rid of that BFRC. And we have Hector doing some upholstery for us. Hey, you didn't put horse manure in the paddings, did you?
Horse manure?
Yeah, that's what they do in Tijuana, I heard, when you get your car reupholstered. So Dahmer, many of you may not know, he is a veteran in the graphic and seat cover business.
It's been a long time.
He worked at N-Style. Ooh. Did you just do the sales, or did you actually do installations and stuff?
No, I was sales.
Yeah.
Rhino was the installer. He's the king.
Yeah. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Is there a chance to get these?
Yeah, it's probably not going to end up too well.
Today's a bag of mixed emotions here at a Rob Healy track rental. And this is the last one ever, potentially. LA County is closing its doors at this end of the month here. And came out to spin my last laps here, if this is indeed the last chance I have. So here with Hoppe and Massa, and I brought Luca Cometti.
Looks like a tattoo.
Yeah. So we just had our first rain of the fall slash winter, and a big group of us are at the luge to celebrate. But it doesn't look that wet right here. Down below is wet. Little bit chilly. But I think we have like seven guys. There we go. Should be good. Don't feel like it rained. following Austin Raymond from Bell Helmets. He works with Ben. Been riding with him quite a bit lately. Got a new set of wheels on my bike last night. I broke my stalkers riding Skyline with the Spanish guys. So I have, Mike at Roy's built me some wheels using I9 hubs, which I like. But I think the rims are called Knox or something. They're much firmer than the stock wheels. Also, I'm stoked because back on Max's tires now. So that feels familiar. But the rims are definitely firm.
I just felt like this crazy burn and pop in my leg. And I knew in the air before I even landed, like, that was it.
This championship now is far from over.
How can you handle adversity and make the best out of it?
Yeah.
Scott teammate. Chase and I have signed up in the father-son class. Maybe not biological father-son, but for sure father-son.
Chilean son? Oh my god, so the Ortiz father and son is... What are you guys, chicken hawks? Eagles? Oh, eagles! Eagles. Good, eagle, let's see the wingspan.
We're ready to flap.
So right now they're scattering, flying Mike Brown's ashes.
All right,
in the first turn.
Moment of silence for the late Mike
Oh, walk of shame.